When I was growing up, surrounded by Punjabi little kids in West Delhi, saying out loud my name used to be a torture session because people would just go like, "Ye kya hai? Iska kya matlab hai?" And you know, when as a child you want like your self defense mechanism is the strongest, so I used to make up these stories about ye to Roman word hai, iska matlab hai love, ya God's gift, ya ye Bible mein hai, you know. And depending on which side of the puberty I was, it would become more adventurous, like it's a Greek word for fertility or goddess of fertility. So I think I learned storytelling early on, right from my telling of my name. I co-founded Black Ticket Films in 2009 with my then friend and now husband, Sushmit Ghosh. We studied together at the AJK Mass Communication Research Center in Jamia. Soon after, we both had this amazing love for non-fiction, for telling stories. But you know, the problem with documentaries in India is that there is this heavy sense of duty to watch it. Mm-hmm. And because of which people don't enjoy watching documentaries. Mm-hmm. So say, go watch a documentary. Now, of course, things have changed, but 2009 or earlier when we were growing up, it wasn't cool to watch documentaries. And one of the things that was important to us, still is, that if a 30-second TV commercial can actually tell us that we want something and make us convert that rupee into a product by creating something cool, then why can't we apply the same aesthetics and principles to telling stories about real people, beautiful stories? And that's the idea. That's the simple thing with which we started Black Ticket Films. I think we were able to do that quite successfully. There were initial setbacks, big failures for the first 1.5 years, because people were like, "Ye kya? You know, you can't do stuff like this. Aap to bahut young hai. Great concept hai, but how are you gonna, you know?" So all those kinds of things when you're pitching things for money. But we continued building our portfolio. And this is also the time, 2009-10, when the DSLRs came as a gift from the universe. So the whole visual language changed. You could go really close. So that was a great blessing, because what we wanted to do, the technology actually supported us in doing that. And we were able to really make the kind of films we wanted to. And then people came on board, and you know, you keep getting work. One of the films that I want to show a little part of it, it's called Dilli. Now, Dilli is a story of Delhi made, and this was created in the backdrop of the Commonwealth Games 2010. It just really bothered us that a host of people were just packed up and put behind big hoardings, or just put on trains and stamped and asked to just go back to their villages because they weren't pretty enough. And so this film started off as a narrative of the city, critiquing this whole idea of development with the hordes of faceless people. So you don't really see an interview of a person. You see the city in all its glory and ugliness. And then that's the constant thought. And there's this particular segment which is really the centerpiece of the film, where we are directly critiquing the CWG. But it was tough to do that portion because we didn't want to use the imagery that was already there. People were bored of watching that in the news channels. Beyond a point, your mind numbs itself, and it doesn't impact you. So we wanted to make that the most impactful story. So it's an 18-minute film, and this little portion was lying empty on the edit. You know, we had the opening and the closing. We had everything figured out. This little portion was left, and I'd like to show you how we addressed it.
अगर आप कभी झुग्गियों में नहीं रहे हो तो आपको इस बात का एहसास नहीं होगा कि झुग्गियों में लोग कैसे रहते हैं, कैसे नहीं रहते।
बांस लाएंगे, रस्सी लाएंगे, बांस को काटे खुटेंगे, चिटाई लाएंगे, उसको बांधेंगे, फिर तिरपाल डालेंगे, फिर रहने का अवस्था होगा। झुग्गी तो झुग्गी है, जमीन आसमान तपता है, तिरपाल गर्म होता है, हम लोग का दम निकलता है मुँह। बारिश होती है तो तिरपाल डालते फिर भी टपकता है। सर्दी में तो अल्लाह ही को मालूम कि कैसे हम लोग जिंदगी काटा हूँ।
आज हम भी अगर यहाँ आके बस गए, हम भी अगर पैसे वाले हो गए, हम भी एक फ्लैट खरीद लिए, तो हम भी तो मतलब दिल्ली वाले कहलाएंगे या और भी पब्लिक कहेंगे ये खास यहाँ का रहने वाले हैं।
ये जो पेड़ है उसके साथ मेरे स्कूल है, उसके पीछे मेरा घर है और मैं वहीं रहती हूँ। 2-3 साल पहले की बात है, हमारे स्कूल के पीछे ना एक ब्रिज बनने लगा, मिट्टी उड़ती थी, गड्ढे खुदते थे, हाँ फिर फ्लाईओवर बनने लगे, फिर ब्रिज बनने लगे, फिर सड़कें बनने लगी, हर जगह खुदाई खुदाई चल रही थी। तो सब कहते थे कि ना यहाँ पे कुछ होने वाला है।
टू आवर फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम अदर कंट्रीज, लेट मी से India is a diverse and beautiful nation. I am sure you will experience it in all its hues and cherish it.
And over 6 lakh laborers are working 24 hours to make Delhi a world-class city ahead of the Commonwealth Games. Now, what is
the... That's a bird's eye view of this fantastic stadium, this roof which you are seeing.
वो जो आपको बड़ा बड़ा लाइटों वाला स्टेडियम दिख रहा है ना, बहुत सुंदर, उसकी जगह पे पहले मेरा घर था, लेकिन अब नहीं है। सरकार ने तोड़ के वहाँ बहुत बड़ा स्टेडियम बना दिया, बड़े बड़े लाइटों वाला।
So Delhi became a very important film for us, and it was a time when you couldn't monetarily buy virality. The film just went viral, and I think what it spoke back to us was also the fact that it's not just about Delhi. The story is just not about Delhi or India, and these are things that we all feel really strong against, and we it's contrary to what we believe in, but we're not able to do anything as individuals, but as artists, as just regular people, if we put our word out there. You know, silence is not an option, and therefore people wanted to share it, and therefore it became so popular, and it's been integrated in the curriculum for 2 universities abroad, and it's a part of an urban development course, etc. So that gives us great joy that the film picks up a life of its own. It's beyond just a visual document that is played at a festival or sits on a website. After Delhi, we made this film called Timbuktu. It's a story about a small village in Andhra. They move from 100% chemical to 100% organic agriculture. And that film went on to win the National Award for Best Documentary on Best Documentary Film Including Agriculture. What it did to, I think what it told us that apart from the fact that an award like the National Award was being open to be given to, we were the youngest awardees at that time, but more importantly, that this style and this way of storytelling was finding more audiences. Mm-hmm. And to get almost like that certification was very meaningful for us. So in the first, I'd say from 2009 to 12, we were able to achieve the original intent of our work. And then the hunger for more came, and that's when we said, okay, so why don't we use our work to create some kind of change, where these are not standalone films. And this is again when social media is completely booming, and people are doing all sorts of things with the digital medium, Facebook especially. And so we were also experimenting in the dark, and we realized that there's a huge captive audience sitting online wanting to watch these small capsule films, and people love stories. So what if we create things for the web? So for the commissioned work, we started pitching that to clients that, you know, instead of long 15-minute, 10-minute films, why don't we make shorter films? But we also started collaborating with other artists. And so one of the films that I want to show you is called Edible Cutlery. It was, we created it with foreign innovator. He was on the brink of bankruptcy when we met him. And because he put his entire life's jama punji into this great innovation which he wanted to do, he wanted to make cutlery that's edible, because plastic cutlery, which carries carcinogens and adds to pollution in the world, disturbed him. But nobody was buying into his idea. So we thought, okay, you know, let's make a film and see what happens. And it's a very short one.
I ordered for idli sambar, and the spoon is put in it. So as he was putting the spoon, I grabbed it from his hand, I ran my thumb on it, it was greasy. I took a sniff of it, it was already smelling of sambar. It's being reused. We know plastic has got so many chemical complexes in it, phthalates, chelates, bisphenols. These cause cancer, these leach into food. They don't biodegrade, but still we're using a whole lot of plastic disposable cutlery. Why are we doing this? Answer obviously is there is no alternative. Oh well, we have an alternative now. We've come up with an alternative, and that is edible cutlery. Here, there is no coating. In fact, it is entirely nutritious. You can eat up the spoon. Delicious. It is made of jowar, blended with rice and wheat without preservatives, just like dehydrated vegetables. Our product also has a very long shelf life of more than 3 years. In fact, you can even have a hot soup also. You can stir your sugar and have your tea. You can eat it up. You don't want to eat it, you can just throw it. It decomposes within 4 to 5 days.
विश्वास नहीं हुआ पहले बार देखे तो लकड़ी समझी मैं मगर काम में स्टार्ट होके काम शुरू किया बाद साग में डाल के अपन खाए बहुत टेस्टी रहता मैडम कभी खाने के चम्मच के बारे में सुना है आपको एक सैंपल देती हूँ आप अगर स्पून को काटेंगे तो स्पून का फ्लेवर आएगा आप इसमें जीरा अजवाइन रॉक सॉल्ट ब्लैक पेपर मिलाते हैं और इसको बेक करते हैं तो आप जब स्पून खाते हैं तो सिर्फ स्पून नहीं खा रहे आप एक जोवार रोटी खा रहे
When it comes to financing this, I had to put the only asset that I have, which is the flat where I'm residing, as a collateral security. And then got the loan, because there's no such technology. We are the first in the world. So the technology had to be created. I brought in this edible cutlery and trying to promote a market for millets and motivate farmers to move away from rice. Plastic is very cheap, true. But I can make it as cheap. I can, with volumes. And once, when I get the volumes, I get on to the farmers directly and start procuring raw materials directly from the farmers, in which case, my spoons will be as cheap as the plastic spoons. So now the cutlery is tasty, fun, nutritious, and environment friendly. That's edible cutlery.
This film, so we put out the film on the internet with collaborating with the Better India as the digital partner, and because they have a great subscriber list already. But it just blew us when the next morning we got a call from Narayana at around 9 o'clock, and he said, I have always get confused. He had orders worth 50 lakhs in the first 12 hours. And eventually, this film was directly responsible for generating 3 crores of revenue. And we're not even counting partnerships where all people from all across the globe wanted to come, design his marketing strategy, etc., etc. And so this is a film which is a part of a 6-part series, the 6th social innovator career profile, which really, you know, how can we use our art to actually create some impact? And that original idea, after 7 years of working and experimenting and failing and doing and creating networks and collaborations, we were able to really crack that code a little bit, which then led to the next phase of our work in which we are right now, that how can we use our work to not just impact change, but also affect transformation, you know, that changes social conversations. How can we do that? How can a film, and how can us as people who know a particular skill, you know, do, I know something, that little quote you read out, I'm good at something, you're good at something, and together we can create something. So I'm running out of time. Thank you so much. We were referred to Lopez by the folks at the Safe Food Campaign, Nachiket. I also only know of them, so it's really, really kind of them to connect us.